Where did your mother spend the night?
I was able to get a hotel room, a motel room for her for $120 a night, because with her sitting in the truck, her legs and her arms start to swell up because of the medication she's on. She can't stay in the truck overnight.
But all the money you have is the money from the cash for keys, right?
Pretty much. My mom does get, you know, my dad's pension, but it's not enough. Most of it goes to her medicine. Her medicine's expensive. She doesn't have insurance.
Can't she be on Obamacare?
She's been trying. No computer. Can't go online. If you're not first down at the library, there's no seats available. Everybody's, if you're not first online, they're all taken.
So you're going to have to keep her in a motel at $120 a night when you've got $1,500 plus the pension check and that's it?
Money's running out quick. I've called all other motels. The cheapest one I can get, $120 a night. I don't know how much longer I'm able to do this and sleep in my truck. What sleep that I did get, 2 hours in 3 days, I don't think I can last much longer.
So what are you going to do?
I don't know. I guess something will be on the news, I guess. I'm out of my mind. I'm losing it. I didn't think it was going to happen to me, but it did. The sleep, no sleep, kills you. Can't eat, I'm overstressed. I'm beyond overstressed. I'm tired of being sick and tired of being sick and tired. It's killing me.
And you can't get a job around here?
Finding a job is a bit hard. I haven't worked in a while since my mom got sick with a heart attack. She's got 4 stents in her. I need to be around to make sure she takes her medicine. I just found out not too long ago that she didn't take her medicine last night. She left her bag in my truck while I had her in a motel room. So I had to stay up all night and hope that when I called her this morning, that she was okay. Because if she doesn't take a medicine, chance she'll die.
Is there any game plan at all? I mean, can you make a deal to live somewhere?
We're trying to go through a couple of places where we might be able to rent to own. But some places need 20% up front, 30% up front. We don't have $20,000.
But if you rent a place first month, last month, I mean, a deposit, you could do that, no?
Most of them don't take dogs. Background check, my brother gets it. He can't live there. There's no sense of us staying there.
So you're really a victim of being too attached to your mother, your brother, and your dogs?
My dogs are my family. My dog, the big one I got, that was the last thing my dad gave to me 6 months before he died. It was a Christmas present. If one place does accept dogs, I'll ask about, you know, going through a background check. Everybody does background checks. Your brother won't get in.
And your brother won't get in because he was charged with improperly touching a minor, a cousin, I guess.
My brother was accused of touching a minor. He was convicted of it. He didn't do it. The paperwork, the witnesses say he didn't do it. It was my other cousin, who's 8 years old, who did it to my female cousin. My brother got accused of it because he didn't get up at 2 o'clock in the morning when he had to be at work at 6 to run across the Highway 22 to go get milk for my aunt.
And your aunt was infuriated because of that?
Yes. My female cousin even said it wasn't Bobby. It wasn't Bobby. She told everybody it wasn't Bobby. Even her mother and my aunt, whose son it was, even told her it wasn't Bobby. Now my brother's marked for the rest of his life.